So something a little different today. I'm going to show you how to use the Photobooth app that comes with your Mac to record with a green screen effect. So notice I don't have my normal black fabric background here. I've just got the white wall. I've even added a picture. You can see it's a real picture here. And I'm going to use Photobooth to create a green screen without a green screen. So you've got this all on your Mac, and it just uses the EyeSight camera built into your Mac. I'm going to run Photobooth. And Photobooth is an app that's great because it allows you to take pictures with your EyeSight camera. So that can come in handy. You can also do video. I'm going to switch to video here. And I'm going to then click on effects. And you have all these different effects, funny different effects. And I'm going to go to the second to last one. And the second to last one's got these green screen effects with these preset backgrounds. So let's use the Eiffel Tower one as a simple example. I'm going to click on that, and it's going to ask me to step out of the frame. And what it's going to do then is it's going to get a picture of what's behind me. And then when I come back in the frame, it's going to subtract that. So basically simulate a green screen. So now I can get back in, and you could see it simulates a green screen. It knows what was there before, so I'm the difference. You can notice it's not perfect, but it's still pretty good. There's a little bit of issues there at the bottom of the Eiffel Tower, but you can also see that it's not a still picture. You can see there's people moving and walking around, so it adds some realism to it. Now, you don't have to just settle for these presets. If I go to effects here, notice that I can go to the last section here, and I've got these different backdrops that are called user backdrops, and I can drag and drop a photo in there. So I put a photo there, and I'm going to say use this backdrop, and it already knows the background here, so it doesn't ask me to step out of the frame again. But if I ever wanted it to, I can go to view, reset effect, and it'll ask me to step out again. So if I move my MacBook, then it will have to reset back there. Even a slight movement will cause the problem. So now I can hit the record button, and it will start recording the video. And now I get video recorded with a green screen. So all those artifacts that you see, like up and down here, that's all because my desk isn't perfectly stable, right? If I shake it a bit, you're going to see more of those. And if I move my MacBook, you can see it really begins to have a problem. You can see actually the shape of the photo that's there that it expects to have there now. So it's how stable your situation is. Both the background behind you and the desk or table or whatever you've got your MacBook on. So you may have to play around with it and readjust it to get it perfect. Having a more stable background, notice here on this side where it was just white, it's a lot better. So having something close to a green screen or something that's definitely a different color than what you're wearing will help. But it doesn't have to be. It can't be a very complex background. You can have bookcases and all sorts of stuff back there, and it will still kind of work. So something fun to play around with, and it works when you just don't have a green screen, but you need to have that kind of effect. Also, I find it works best with the EyeSight cameras built into your Macs. It doesn't really work too well with third-party cameras you add in. There's a lot of noise in those. Even the one I use for recording, it couldn't get a good stable image. It kept saying there was too much movement. So it may not work great with third-party cameras, but still fun to play around with and try.